them. Thank you. Thank you very much. Please take your seats. Thank you. Thank you very much. Chairman NRC, Chairman CASA, our guests from Nepal, my council colleagues, distinguished guests, members of the ICAP, and my dear students, Assalamu Alaikum. Today, when I heard your and saw what you commented here, I felt that you consider yourself in a disadvantageous position. Doing training is a disadvantageous position. Am I correct? Many of you believe that you are stressed. Correct? Correct impression? Okay. If you believe that you are stressed out, if you believe that you are in a disadvantageous position, then let me explain my position. And I'm sure when I'll explain my position to you, many of you will start crying. I'm here when the program is 1 hour behind the schedule. They put me here after Farooq Wasi and Max Babri. And I am between two very interesting things, food and the musical program. And the last, before sending me here, Chairman NRC said that you can hear the clatter of crockery and you can smell the food also. So please be brief. So if you are in a disadvantageous position, I believe that tonight I am in a bigger disadvantage standing here. So I'll follow his advice and I'll be brief. First of all, I would like to appreciate CASA and the regional committee. They are doing wonders. This year was perhaps the most activity-filled year I have seen in ICAP. And it was not just activity. The quality of all the activities is superb. It's the CASA. Every now and then we hear that CASA is holding a sports tournament, CASA is holding a conference, CASA is doing this and CASA is doing that. And CASA is not only providing you entertainment, CASA is providing you education as well. So when your exams come, CASA arranges some teachers and they come for quick revisions, and that is a great help for the students. And CASA could not have done all this without the support of NRC. So a big hand for both CASA and NRC. The training, my dear students, the training you obtain during 3.5 years in this profession, I've tried to find its parallel in other professions, and I fail. What do you think this training is all about? Teaching you some technical skills, teaching you how to do audit. We would have gone for simulation if you wanted to teach you how to do audit and how to fill tax returns. It would have been much more quicker and much more economical. This training is actually teaching you, training you how to live a life in which you will interact with the people under the supervision of your seniors, your managers, and the partners. You would learn to talk to your clients. You would learn to handle a difficult client who is not willing to provide you information. It would help you learn to talk. It helps you actually learn to talk to people, to influence them, to obtain information from them. If you are trying to handle a stern partner, if you are if you are being irritated by poking semi-senior, or if you are trying to manage the time and the late sittings, this training is precisely meant to teach you all these things. Because in the life, in your life after training, you are going to face all this. You will not be able to complain to anyone. There would be late sittings in life. There would be difficult people to handle. There would be irritating juniors in industry as well. And you will have to learn to work in a team. You will be working in a team throughout your life. And all these skills will help you learn how to manage a good family life also. So this training is not just training of some skills. I believe out of 3.5 years, if we calculate the time, for 3 years, we teach you how to be emotionally intelligent, not how to be a competent chartered accountant. For 3 years, we teach you how to handle people, how to go along with people. So please value this training. Don't be irritated if you are sitting late. Just think that this is part of your training. If you are being grilled by your manager, please do not be irritated. That is the training you need, because later on, many people would come to grill you. And if you are trained to handle such people, you will not be depressed in your life. Life is not going to be the way you desire it. Life is going to be the way it is. And the more you adjust yourself according to the situation, the more happier you will be. You will become chartered accountants. I am very confident about that, that you will become chartered accountants. It is not going to be very difficult for you. All of you have the potential to become chartered accountants. But is it the end of the world when you become chartered accountant? Is it the end of learning? I believe no. As long as you live, you will have to learn. You will be learning and you should be learning. Many people are talking about what the world is going to be after 20 years and 25 years. It's anybody's guess. If someone would have asked me 30 years ago, what would be life in 2018? I tell you, I would have been proven wrong today. I was reading an essay written by a very famous historian, Arnold Toynbee. Toynbee was a great historian and a great thinker of his time. After Second World War, Toynbee visited many countries of Europe, and he also went to USA. He himself was an English. And then he wrote that essay and said that what I have seen in this world, I believe that in times to come, people will have a lot of free time. They will be working perhaps 2 days in a week, and for 5 days they will be enjoying their lives. When I read that essay, I started laughing. A man of Toynbee's stature, we cannot match his talent, we cannot match his wisdom. A man of Toynbee's wisdom, had he been alive today, he would have realized how wrong he was. Today we work 7 days a week, not 5 days, not 2 days. Today we work 7 days a week. Previously, when I used to leave my office at 5, that was end of it. But now I carry my office to my home. 15 years ago, nobody ever could have imagined that how computer is going to change our lives. Is it going to be a big machine on my desktop, or I would be carrying it in my pocket? Nobody could have imagined. So with such uncertainty in future, what do we need to learn? We need to learn flexibility. We need to learn adaptability. And this training is designed in a manner where you can be flexible. You learn flexibility. You adjust yourself in different situations. And believe me, no other institute is going to provide opportunity for such a wonderful training to an 18 years or 20 years old. No other profession offers this opportunity at such a young age. And that is the hallmark of this profession. So if we take this training positively, this is the life skill we are going to learn or we are learning. So be happy. If at the end of the day, you're not happy, this is the message of today's conference, I believe. I have heard two eminent speakers, both motivational, and both emphasize this thing that at the end of the day, a life is not worth living if it is not a happy life. So how can you be happy? Please accept this reality, this fact that you are doing your training, and this training is going to do a lot of good in your life. Don't take it as a beggar labor. Isko forced labor or prison labor ke context mein na lein, ye training hai. Ye training hai, life skills ki training hai. Ye audit ki, tax ki, in cheezon ki training nahi hai. Ye aap jaate hain, clients se milte hain, baatein karte hain. I tell you, this training has changed my life. When I left college, I couldn't talk to anyone. I was such a shy person. At that time, I could not imagine that one day I will be standing here and addressing you. But this training changed me. I've seen many young men being changed by this training. So, what you need to learn? I believe you need to learn the confidence. Confidence to talk to people, confidence to handle the world. You need to learn to respect others. You will not be a good chartered accountant, you will not be a good professional if you fail to respect people. People will not respect you. And please respect yourself. As Max very ably put it, that you have to tell yourself that you are wonderful. You are wonderful. So that is the self-respect. You will be a very learned person one day in your life. You still are very learned. If I compare you with myself 30 years ago, I believe today's generation is more learned than we were. They have more knowledge, better knowledge. So please be humble. When you are a learned person, please be humble. And please be pleasant. Nobody wants to talk to an unpleasant person. If you want people to come near you, if you want people to talk to you, please be pleasant. Meet people with a smiling face. Even if you are under stress, a smile is a smile. It is only some story writer who would be able to distinguish between a false smile and a real smile. Most of the people will not be able to distinguish between a false smile and a real smile. So please wear a smile on your lips. And in America, they carried out a research on 2,000 school students. And they continued to monitor them till they became professionals or they started their practical life. And after that, after such a long research, they published the results. And one of the results was that students who in school delayed gratification were more successful in their lives later on. Those who ate their chocolates there and then were less successful in their practical lives, and those who kept their chocolates for a while and then ate those, they were more successful in their lives. Those who preferred to study first and play later were more successful in their lives, practical lives, as compared to the students who played first and studied later. So in CA, what you are doing at the age of 20, 21 and 22, your other class fellows from school days or from college days might be attending universities, still attending universities. They might be enjoying their life, but later on they might be struggling more. So please take it positively that your delayed gratification will bring great success to you. Enjoy your work, enjoy your life. And how can you enjoy your life? There are two things, I would say. Learn to ignore. This is a great art you will have to learn. You cannot take notice of everything. When you start taking note of everything, you become tense, you become irritable, you become depressed. So try to learn to ignore. And please be less judgmental. We are in a profession where we have to exercise our judgment. When we were students and we used to study these ISAs, these were two-page ISAs and everything was left to our judgment. Now these are more than 100 para ISA. Each ISA is more than 100 paragraphs and they are bringing that judgment into certain context. So they are teaching you how to exercise your judgment. But during the last 30 years, we as a society have become more judgmental. We keep on judging people on the basis of our own beliefs, on the basis of our own religion, on the basis of our own cultural background. Please learn to accept diversity among the people. Learn to accept that there can be two points of view for everything and both can be right. Please learn to tolerate people the way they are. Don't try to make them the way you want them. Accept your juniors the way they are. Accept your seniors the way they are. And they will start accepting you the way you are. So that is the lesson of today. Thank you very much. Thank you.